Hi Pi fans, here's a short video talking about the power consumption of the new Pi 3 A Plus compared to some of the older models such as the Pi 3 B Plus and the original A Plus. Hi everyone, this is a short video where I talk about the power consumption figures for the new Pi 3 A Plus and compare it to the older boards such as the original A Plus, the Pi 3 B Plus, the standard Pi 3 and the older B Plus models. Now these are just some basic tests, but what I use is this device here, which is a Porter power current and power meter. And what you do is you feed in your normal power supply into this USB cable here, and then you feed the Pi from this output here, and then on the display you can measure the watts used or the milliamp hours used just by changing this mode here, and it can also keep a running count of how long it's been running for. So what I tend to do is I tend to run a test for about 10 minutes, measure how many milliamp hours it's used, and then that can help you just get an average current used over that time. And when it's powered up, this voltage here will read 5 volts if everything's working okay. So that's what I use. It seems to be accurate enough for these sort of purposes. It's quite a good device and it doesn't cost that much. So the tests I ran was to create a card with just a standard Raspbian image on the latest one at the time of recording. And then what I did was I just measured the current used when the desktop was running, but nothing else going on, with and without Wi-Fi. And then I did two other tests where I played a YouTube video just using the Chromium browser, and also played a 1080p MP4 file which I just launched in OMX Player on the command line. And so what that gave me was a number of readings for each of these models. So here are the results overall. So you can see the numbers for each of the devices, for the desktop, the playing the video, playing the YouTube video, and for the desktop and the playing the MP4 video, I did both versions with the Wi-Fi on and off. And generally you got a consistent drop when you turn the Wi-Fi off. And it was reasonably consistent actually on all versions of the Pi 3. It tended to be about 35 to 40 milliamps. So what I found was the original A Plus has the lowest power consumption. The 3B Plus has the highest power consumption. So in order, it's A Plus, 3A Plus, B Plus, 3B and the Pi 3B Plus with the highest power consumption. These results aren't that surprising. That's probably the order most of you were expecting. So playing a 1080p video from the command line tended to add about 15 to 20 milliamps, whereas playing a YouTube video via the Chromium browser tended to add about 50 or 60 milliamps. What my tests don't do is really tax the Pi 3 and its 4 cores. So what you might find is these values don't necessarily reflect the maximum power you're going to get drawn from a Pi 3. You would have to do something a bit more intensive to sort of draw that out of the device. But the idea of these tests was just to give a really quick comparison between as many devices as possible, just with some basic tasks, just to give you a bit of an idea. But the Pi 3 obviously has capacity there to use up a lot more current if you put it to work a bit harder. So those are my results. Obviously the measuring device I'm using is fairly basic, so they're only as accurate as that device. I believe that my numbers will at least show the relative difference between the devices. If you run the tests again, you sometimes get slightly different results. However, I hope that these numbers are useful to you in deciding what Pi you might use for a particular project, or to give you an idea of what the impact might be if you're going to basically replace an older Pi with one of the newer models. Anyway, thanks for watching, and until the next time, goodbye.